Hi, my name is Mary O'Malley, and I'm a GTD coach. Today, I'm here to share my GTD setup, and my list manager is Trello. Now, I've already recorded one video where I shared my inbox, my next action list, waiting for, and how I track projects. So, if that is of interest to you, go ahead and stop this video and watch that one instead. We'll go ahead and link that in the description below for you. Today, I'm going to be showing you how I personally handle things that show up in the question, is it actionable? No, on the workflow map. So, what am I talking about? Let me show you. This is the workflow clarifying and organizing map. And one of the questions we ask as we clarify and organize is it actionable? If the answer is no, you should focus over here on the workflow map. And your choices are you can eliminate it, incubate it, or reference it. So in Trello, eliminate is either archive or delete. In incubate, it says someday maybe lists or folders, but on Trello for me, that's a someday maybe board. And same with reference, it says digital lists or folders. And so reference for me, that's a reference board. So I'll go ahead and show you my setup. This is my Trello inbox, and I've left one thing in here to show you. It says new phone, important instructions for your trade-in promotion. I am finally getting a new phone. Yay. And this is not actionable for me. It is just in case something happens. There's nothing here that I need to do, but I do need to have this. So I've put it into a card in Trello and it's in my inbox. And now I'm going to move it. You can see all my different boards here. I'm moving it to reference. Now I have different lists in reference. And because this particular thing to do with my phone doesn't have anything to do with eat or read and watch or travel, I'm going to put it in general reference and I'm going to put it in the last position and go ahead and move it. You can see it is gone from my inbox and now it's in my reference. Here it is at the bottom, just where we put it in general reference list, position number 6. If I change my mind, I can always move it to the top of that list. Generally, I just drop it and forget it. So here are my reference lists. I have eat, read and watch, and travel. I wanted to show you this one read and watch card because I often take pictures of things on my phone, and then I will put that picture, attach it to a card in Trello to clarify and organize later into my system. I often don't remember the names of things, but for example, with this, I would remember that the book I wanted to investigate to see if my kids would like has bold writing and it has two kids on the front. I wouldn't remember the name. So hunting by the name would do me no good. But this is a really great trigger and I know exactly what it is when I see it. So this feature of Trello is very, very helpful for me. I also do this by I will put the URL into the title of the card. And sometimes you can see here for this one, it doesn't do it. But for this, it brings up the logo of the restaurant. And that is really helpful. That's often how I remember things. Another piece in reference, which I really appreciate, is how built out you can make each individual card. So, for example, my family goes to Idlewild quite a bit, and I have some quick references. Sometimes I'll add lists of things. Oh, I'd like to do this next time we're here. It's not an action item per se, but maybe before I go on the trip, I might reference this card, look through this reference, and then add a next action into my list. But here's where all the things that my reference support for all the things that we like to do when we're in Idlewild. Vacation cabin rentals, good website that lists good hikes to go on. I don't have to hunt for these over and over again. I just link them in Trello and they're very easy for me to find. I can also add attachments for things, which allows me to comment and download. It's just a really nice way to build out a reference system in a way that works for me. Now, in addition to reference on that no section of the workflow map, there is someday maybe. So here's my someday maybe board. You can see that I don't have one big long list. Some clients do. That really works for them. That works for you, go for it. For me, I have no resistance whatsoever to scrolling horizontally. That's generally what I like to do. So you can see here, once again, I've attached a picture for reference and also for novelty. And then I did not add a verb to this card. I just put the URL in the title. I know that this means I want to look into these workshops and classes to do. And I like, once again, having the visual there. If I add words, it won't link the URL in the same way. So I make the choice to do that or not to do it. Someday maybe are cards that are going to be actionable for me if I choose to make them actionable in the future. So generally, as I clarify and organize, I add verbs and then I can seamlessly move them into the next actions or projects part of my system, or delete them out if I decide I'm just going to release it to the universe and it's not anything I'm going to do. Something else I wanted to demonstrate that I use quite a bit in Trello is the search function. So I can put in a keyword or phrase that I remember using, or I might think might be attached to this card. You can see here all the things with kids that came up. You can also see find new pediatrician came up. That doesn't have the keyword kids on it, but it is linked. There's a theme there. So I think that's pretty cool that Trello does that. Now, as I scroll over these options that came up in my search, this is nothing really interesting, but you can see here, there's that picture of that was on the card. So if you, like me, are really visual, you remember the way things looked, this might be a really nice hack for you. I definitely use this quite a bit. So I can click on this card and it takes me to it immediately. And then if I click out, it takes me to the board where the card was. So we started this search on someday maybe. Now we're on reference. So this is my Trello setup for reference and someday maybe. I started you in my inbox and showed you how I clarify and organize things too, in this example, my reference board. And then I also showed you the way that I have mine organized, in addition to some of the functionality and features I use on the different cards. I also showed you the search function and how that can be really helpful as your reference grows and becomes more robust, helps you find things easily without having to scroll horizontally or vertically, depending on how you have your system oriented. I will be doing another video on lists, how I use lists in Trello, and also my tickler, how I use that in this Trello setup. So stay tuned for those. If this video was helpful for you, please go ahead and like and subscribe. Always feel free to comment in the chat. I do read everything and I endeavor to respond to as much as possible. And thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.
For more GTD resources, visit davidco.com and David Allen's YouTube channel. To explore coaching, email info@gtdfocus.com or visit gtdfocus.com and click Talk to a Coach.